My name is Mike Paco, Director of Product Marketing at Okta, and you're listening to the Meet Your Okta Identity Expert podcast. It's a series of podcasts where we bring Okta's professional service experts to share their experiences and knowledge of how they've managed our customers' identity in today's online world. At Okta, I focus on mobile access management and user lifecycle management, and I'm one of our subject matter experts for helping our customers automate the onboarding and offboarding process for new employees and managing the people they work with in the extended enterprise, such as contractors, partners, and suppliers. For today's podcast, we're going to discuss an HR-driven approach to onboarding and offboarding employees with Okta's services architect, Krish Venkatraman. Welcome, Krish.
Hi, Mike. Thanks for inviting me.
Well, before we dive into our topic, I was hoping you can give us a little bit about your background and what brought you to Okta.
Sure, Mike. I started my career almost 14 years ago as a network engineer and server administrator. I worked on many technologies like LANVAN and also gaining fundamental knowledge of OAS and also network layers. The next phase of my career was as an application architect with a focus on security and identity and access management. In this role, I use my substantial experience and knowledge gained over my past years to solve some complex challenges like onboarding employee and customer identities. Throughout my career, I have performed progressively challenging security and identity-related roles in engineering, development, and also architecture design, spanning product, consulting, and manufacturing industries.
You know, like you, I started my career in IT, and my work spanned across many different areas, software development, networking. But you know, the one thing I eventually realized, you know, in my different experiences is that I really wanted to work for a company that was creating IT solutions that helped a broad array of companies. And that's what brought me to Okta. So I'm curious, what brought you specifically to Okta?
Sure, Mike. Yeah, that's exactly the same thing. I want to work in a product company, really, like Okta. And also, this is my first startup experience, to be honest. So I learned about Okta and its products while working as a technical lead for a manufacturing company. And I was really focused on identity and access management team. And also, I was doing some research to find a state-of-art identity and access management tool to design, implement, and managing customer and employee identities. Because, you know, those days, Sun got acquired by other company, Oracle, and then Oracle was really removing some of the product areas. So we want to really see what is our next type of product. And we want to really go to cloud. That's where we saw Okta as one of the potential product for us. So that's where I saw Okta's capabilities and also really challenging technology and everything. And being worked in many consulting and other industries, it was really a great switch for me, and I really wanted to work for a product.
You know, like you, I find that actually using Okta is one of our best recruiting tools, you know, across the company. Can you spend some time and tell us a little bit more about the types of companies that you've helped?
Sure. In my almost 5 years at Okta, I worked with customers ranging from small to large enterprises. I almost helped customers across the world, starting from US, Canada, APAC, and Europe. I remember those days where we started our APAC operations, where I needed to travel to Australia, and we used to meet a lot of customers. It was really a great experience, I would say. Most of the customers are somewhere with their digital transformation journey, adapting to new cloud products. As an architect in professional services, I get to design and architect solutions for our customers and make their journey successful and mostly a secured one.
You know, when you mentioned the adoption of new cloud services as part of the digital transformation, you know, it immediately reminded me of NextTier Automotive's presentation at Octane 18. You know, they talked about their move to a cloud-based HR solution, SuccessFactors, and the benefits they realized by connecting it to Okta. You know, some of the highlights were 300 hours of savings in HR change requests. They estimated $150,000 a year in savings by onboarding and offboarding automatically. You know, I was wondering if you could, you know, share some similar examples.
Yeah, definitely, Mike. I think onboarding employees is an ongoing problem area for many of our customers. Biggest problem is they could not onboard and offboard employees in timely fashion. Also, lots of manual processes, integrations, and operations over it. Designing correct integration methods and industry best practices in terms of security solutions for HR-driven ID provisioning to ease onboarding process is one of my four. So refer to the birthrights, if you talk about birthrights, because onboarding is not just onboarding, right? I'm not just bringing in users into Okta. Now I need to also start provisioning to downstream Active Directory, and there are a lot of applications downstream. So how do I provision those? Those are also on day one when I joined the company, I need to get access because I don't want to lose my
employees to lose the productivity. So that's one of the key things, you know, like where like a company has a lot of issues. So that's where like Okta, like we have a lot of out of the box features like SuccessFactors, like you said, like SuccessFactors implementations, like Workday as a master, so we call it as a master integrations. So we do a lot of this for customers, like where they onboard on day one or before day one, like we call this pre-hire, and they get access to it. All basic birthrights like email, Active Directory credentials, everything on day one, so that like they can start their work immediately on day one.
You mentioned onboarding employees is a challenge for a lot of organizations. Can you deep dive into a customer example of some of those challenges and how you help them overcome them?
Sure. One of our enterprise customers wanted us to design a solution to onboard their employees in real time as they were offered a job in job fair. You know, like the huge problem with hiring these people is basically like, if they're not, they need to do some pre-hire paperwork in job fair because there are a lot of companies trying to offer the job. And this is like very like, for this customer is a very, very like key, like in consumer space where they're not able to hire properly because of their pre-hire paperwork problem, where like they're getting emails lately or something like that. So where they got some other job offer, so they're not able to hire properly. So what Okta did is basically like they want to do in pre-hire, they want to get a paperwork immediately, they want to do everything on day one, on the pre-hire day, so on the job fair. So what we did is we used our out-of-the-box integrations, and then like we set up like pre-hire. So where like on when they get a job fair hire, they get an email activation email right away at that same day, and then they can go and fill in their paperwork and they can onboard smoothly.
No, that's great. Now we were talking about some of the challenges like you described and how you overcame them. Let's move back more to the beginning of the process. You know, what are some of the key questions you ask or think about before engaging with a customer to help them?
Yeah, that's an interesting question, I would say, because like most importantly, like first of all, like you need to like study their existing HR business processes and provisioning procedures, because always like everybody has their own business process. It could be like a very old legacy process where we need to modernize it, or we need to think about like how we can change this to adapt to our process. Because our goal is to make sure that IT and HR works together, and also make sure that we get everything automated throughout this journey. So one of the key things is to study their HR business process, as I said, and also like identify any manual process they do, and also any complex provisioning logics due to old practices, right? These are usually have a high maintenance cost. I need to like every time, for example, like if I write a script, I need to go and like update the scripts every time. For example, like newer version of PowerShell comes into play. Now I need to go and update the PowerShell, otherwise like my script is not going to run tomorrow. So these are some of the biggest like complex challenges. So how do we automate those? These are some of the things is what like we need to take in consideration, and we work with the customer, take their like understand, basically like read about their process, existing process, so that we can design a proper solution for them and also automate the best way like we can.
You know, you talked a lot about process and thinking about, you know, the directions you need to go in order to, you know, automate and realize the benefits. You know, one of the things that I've experienced working with our customers is that the next level of challenge is not the technical challenge or the process challenge, but how do we get the different teams that need to collaborate together, HR and IT, in order to buy into this solution and able to implement it? You know, an example of a customer that I worked with, the HR team did not want another system connecting to HR. They were unsure of what data would be visible. How would they control that? You know, so what are some of the things that you do in your engagements to really bring together and improve the relationship between HR and IT so that they can implement this vision?
Yeah, that's always been a challenge for me. Even like in my past companies, I know that this is exactly we had problems because these two different teams. And then there's always like gaps, like where if you want to do like successful onboarding, obviously you want to make sure that they are onboarded as well. So I know that I always find like whenever I go for a design session or architect session, I actually like always find a way to provide HR some automation with Okta. For example, HR always tend to send CSV files to IT and also expect some sort of CSV file back from IT to feed HR systems, where the system needs some contact information like phone number and email address, which are originated outside HR system, right? So Okta provides capabilities to automate this entire workflow. When we provide these automation, these provide actually like some comfort and removal operational overhead for HR team as well. So they are so motivated and also ready to streamline this process and also more importantly work with the IT on this.
You know, that's great. You know, I'm gonna take a slightly different tact for the next question, because one of the things, you know, that I've experienced as I've hung out in our kitchenettes around the office, they say that if you need to get HR as a master done, or you need an identity guru, Krish is the guy to go talk to. So what has made you the trusted partner of so many customers?
Sure. I mean, like, as I said before, like, I've been here for like almost like 5 years now with Okta, and doing my tenure here, like, having worked on almost all the Okta product lines, because I've had the opportunity to design and architect solutions to many of our Okta global customers. As I said before, I worked in the area, like, almost all the regions here in Okta. And also, like, this experience has helped me gain our customers' confidence and also become their trusted advisor. And also, like, additionally, when we presented with use case, I always design and architect a long-term solution for our customers, because this builds the trust and referenceable customers for Okta. Because without, like, if you're solutioning just for what they bought, that's not going to, like, you know, make them really, like, successful. We need to see the long-term strategy so that the customer always trusts us and come back to us.
Now, that's great. You know, we've talked about the benefits of the solution. We've talked about some of the challenges of bringing different groups and teams together. I was wondering if you can just give me the high-level example of a customer engagement. You know, what does that framework look like? And what would it be like working with yourself to go this project from the beginning to end?
Sure. I mean, I can take one customer example, like how we've done, and also like how professional service is important here. So, for example, like, you know, like, one of the customers rolling out like an HR system, whole new HR system, and they had a huge problem with setting up onboarding and offboarding workflows with this new system. And also, like, they are new to this. HR itself is new to this because they are learning some new product, and also they are trying to deploy this, and they don't know, like, what sort of issues going to come up and, like, how they're going to architect this, because this everything is new for them. They want to, like, set up this from base thing, but they want to get this right. So how do we help them, right? So I was engaged as an architect, and also, like, with our broad experience, like, with many customers, because we know, like, what are the challenges they face day to day on an HR to IT provisioning. So with our experience, and also, like, worked with many customers on the same product line, for example, like, they got with, like, HR product, which we have a deep integration. So we worked with many customers on that product. So, like, I was able to quickly, like, know the, like, problems with that product lines, and also what sort of, like, limitations with the product lines. I was able to quickly draft, like, a design, like, a nice architecture for them. This also, like, not just, like, with Okta architecture, right? This also gave them the ability to, like, design some sort of, like, business process in HR system as well, which gave them more, like, you know, like, onboarding automation and stuff.
That sounds really good. You know, many times when I interact with customers and start discussing, you know, many of the benefits and capabilities of our automated onboarding and offboarding, you know, one of the things that I typically always find, in spite of the fact that we support many HR systems out of the box, there's always solutions that we don't have out of the box integrations for. So what do we do in those scenarios?
Right. I mean, this is where professional services provides more value to end customers, because customers always need some help in automating this workflow with our enhanced outbound provisioning to Active Directory and other applications. We help customers to integrate their HR systems using their Okta APIs. So Okta provides a lot of APIs, and also we have, like, something called on-prem provisioning connector, where we also, like, have, like, enhanced integration for this custom integrations which is not in our Okta application network. So either we use a flat CSV file and automate these business processes, or we work with the customer and their HR service provider to integrate directly using their APIs, so that, like, we can make sure that everything comes in real time as our Okta integration. Okta also supports, like, SCIM 2.0 protocol, so where we can connect to any provider who supports this standard provisioning mechanism. And also, like, we are also working towards, like, something like CSV as a master or something, so that, like, we can provide, like, some sort of more value to the customers, because some of the HR systems, to even, like, integrate through the API, they charge some money. Like, they want to make sure that customer pay for it. And we also know that burden as well. So we also want to make sure that we provide right support to them, so we choose the right architecture for them.
No, that's great. And the nice thing to hear is that pretty much anyone who's using Okta, they can leverage their existing HR system with the help of our professional services team. You know, while we all live and breathe identity and security at Okta, you know, what are some of the things that you do outside of work to keep your mind sharp, as well as, you know, reinvigorate?
Sure. I mean, being a geek, like, I like tinkering with new software and hardware, because, as I said before, like, I started from hardware world, like, and I was starting with network LAN and WAN. So I have, like, a lot of experience with this. So, and also, like, perfect example is like, we recently moved into a new home and I started a smart home project to control like all of my systems remotely. It is a great learning lesson for me. I really enjoy setting up these things like and learning new technology every day. Security market is so grown up. Also, like, I'm a big time video game player. So cricket is one of my favorite games too. I play weekends to stay fit. And also, like, cricket is really like one of my most enjoyable game. The most important time I spend is like with my wife and also my 3-year-old daughter. It makes me like perfect.
No, I agree. I like to spend a lot of time with my family. And you, like you, I'm also a geek and I get really involved in all these latest and greatest gadgets and software apps. And if you looked at my phone, you'd find it quite interesting. You know, one of the areas that I also like to touch in is that, you know, you mentioned a lot about working with customers, but what is it that you really find, you know, personally exciting or passionate about working with the customers? So what gets you excited?
Sure. I mean, in today's like cybersecurity, well, like, you know, identity and access management is really important for organizations and also individual alike. It is like keys to the kingdom, right? And if you have a knowledge and experience to help design and secure the keys, why not, right? That's really like motivating for me there, right there. And then like outside of work, I'm also like active on many social media and other websites. This is just to give an example. Like these days, like, you know, we have lots of identities on multiple websites. Sometimes like without proper thought process, users need to like understand like, you know, what they are signing up for when it comes to sharing their identity. In my role at Okta, I'm really focused on like integrating our customers' applications with their user identity. In doing so, like being a glue that brings it all together, we also get to learn like about application themselves. That's really motivating for me because like I'm not just learning Okta here. I'm also like learning like applications. Every day there's a new application in the cloud coming up like one by day. It could be like a security application or it could be an HR application. Anything that comes in the cloud is a new application. And it's also market is like growing a lot. And it's also like to stay top of the market, you just need to make sure that you understand all the application integration so you can be a best architect so that like, you know like what are the like challenges with the applications as well.
Now that sounds great. So if someone came up to you and said, Krish, this sounds amazing. So what do I do to get started? What's like the first thing that I need to do?
Sure, like I think like the best thing is like you should start contacting your professional services through your Okta account representative because so that you can really like unleash the potential of Okta. So we can come and do some sort of discovery and provide you a secured architecture that can help your goals. And again, we are always on.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, I'd like to, you know, wrap up our discussion with some of the things we discussed today. You know, first, you know, identity is really a fundamental technology that really gives you the platform and the ability to make a long-term decision that'll help you and your organization go through a digital transformation. And that many organizations struggle with the onboarding and offboarding of new employees. And so the combination of connecting an HRS system with Okta can really help you eliminate a lot of those manual processes, improve the communications between IT and HR, and create a great end-user experience for that new employee who on day one gets access to all the apps that they need to get their job done. So with that, I'd like to thank you for your time today.
Thank you so much for having me, Mike. It's really a great talk so far.
And thank you again, Krish, for joining us today and sharing your experiences. To our audience, thank you for joining us, and be sure to stay tuned for another session of Meet Your Okta Identity Expert podcast.
Stay tuned.